My name is Pan. Today I'm here to share with you some of my work, some of my journey in life. To me, creativity as a way of life simply means connecting to people on a very emotional level. I love this quote by Brett Harris that says that the beauty of collaboration between older and younger generations is that we combine wisdom with strength. And that has been my guiding principle all this while. During the circuit breaker, we were asking ourselves as a communications agency, what can we contribute to Singapore during a time like that? We have huge respect for the delivery industry because I think when we want yummy food, we just go online and we just through the app, we order all the food and they'll be delivered to us. They brave the rain, the sun and the virus while we stay safe at home. So we thought that must be something that we can do. So that was the inspiration. And I will share a bit, a very simplified thought process, okay? So this is typically how when we work on a campaign, we will brainstorm and we have a thought process. So how can we launch a campaign without stepping out of the house since we are in a lockdown? That's the first question. How do we get a message out without us printing anything so that resource is almost $0? The reason it has to be $0 is because it's all self-initiated, self-funded. We weren't paid for this project. And how do we make use of the thousands of existing front doors and home printers owned by others to help promote our campaign? $0 resource again. How do we get the audience to like, share and participate in this campaign? And how do we get the media to be interested in this story? So all these were questions leading to the solution. So usually when we start working on something, we will ask ourselves a lot of questions. Then from there, we will sort out and we will find an idea from it. So this was from Cheryl. She says that I heard government projects are boring, blah, 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 blah. So I think my response to her was quite straightforward. Actually, projects from government or the private sectors can equally be exciting or boring. Actually, I feel that we shouldn't spend time worrying about whether the project is boring or exciting, but you just spend the time to work on the best ideas. Because once you take up a project, you have the full responsibility to make it the best. So initially, the brief from the client was to curate a photo exhibition that will feature photo essays of volunteers in acts of kindness, probably like giving out food or helping. So to me, I do have a visual that I think after people look, I think if it's an exhibition and people run through maybe the 10th photo, they'll think, oh, I don't want to see any more of this, right? So I felt that since it was a pro bono project, I was a bit reluctant to work on a direction that I was not comfortable. So again, this comes back to the same thing. You need to be authentic to yourself when you work on a project. You need to know that if you're not feeling it, then you need to talk about it. Because I think end of the day, if the project turns out good, it's good for everyone. So to me, hundreds of photos in people in need create sympathy and not empathy, and I don't think that's the direction I want to take. Then I thought, can't we tell a kindness story in a less cliche way? Because every time we talk about kindness story, we'll be thinking of one kind of story. So we think, how do we tell it differently? One of my creative guys brought up, isn't helping people a good thing? Then this good thing came about, and can we humanize the good thing? And why don't the things and objects become the main cast of the story? So we totally turned it around. Instead of showing people, we show the objects. Then, after looking at the object, it told the story of the people behind it. So I thought that was a bit more engaging and more meaningful and very different. Creativity is not about becoming a designer, painter, or someone in the art business. Creativity is a behavior and a way of thinking. It can become second nature, similar to breathing. So the reason why I say this is because, like, a lot of people have the misconception that Claire and I want to raise our kids as designers and artists. Actually, that's totally not true. What we had in mind was to just use that as a platform to teach them how to properly do a project. So when you start a project, the discipline will be you must complete the project, you must do the project well, you must be able to look back and say, how can we do it better the next time, and so on and so forth. So now, we started in 2011 with this family project. This year is our 10th year. And I can tell you that they are not like better with art. They are not like better with their studies, but at least we feel very close-knitted as a family. Now my son is into fitness. My daughter is into reading lots of books and and she wants to write, right? Next time in the future, I think she might want to go into some writing. So again, it's not whether whatever we are doing or what we are teaching, we want them to be someone in the creative business. But I do think that we can think creatively so that we can tackle life's challenges in a creative way, not in an artistic way only.